Doubt come in. And what happened with this obstacle? We see these obstacles. So here's the question right here. What are the mountain obstacles in your life right now? How do you overcome them? We got to start speaking to them and not about them. Come on now. You got to start talking to them. I don't care what's going on in that. It's about talking to them. It's about saying, I am not going to accept what God did not send. I am not signing for a package that God did not send to me. That I'm now going to talk to my mountain instead of talking about my mountain. My spiritual principle number one. Now, you ready? So now this, we're going to have this with all month long. Read this with me, please. God, I have a big problem. All more important, keep going. Problem, I have a big God.
Amen.
So when David saw Goliath, he didn't see how big Goliath is. Oh, he's a big boy. David saw how big his God was. So yeah, God, I got a problem here. The incredible God, I had some problems, some big and some small. You being God, you delivered me from them all. Still can't believe all the ways you made. An incredible God deserves. Anybody here, have you ever just sat back and wondered how you made it where you are right now? And all the doors that should have closed and things that should not have worked out. It's an incredible God who deserves some incredible praise. I've had some problems, big and small. But so problem, I don't care how big you are, my God is big. Got to talk to my problem, talk to my obstacle, and not just about it. Here's spiritual principle number two to introduce this week. And again, every month, every week, we're going to have a different spiritual principle. Because really, these are the tenets that underlie and undergird overcoming. That everybody wants to overcome, but people are not willing to do what it takes to overcome. If you want to see manifestation like Sister Neal sees, you got to do what you need. You can't sit back and doubt. And can't sit back and worry. And can't sit back and just accept everything. Got to make up in your mind, I believe what the word says. And I don't care what I feel like right now. I don't care what it looks like right now. I don't care what it seems like right now. I am going to stand on and believe and trust and rely on the word. Spirits got to stop talking to the problem. And not just about the problem. Here's spiritual principle number two. Oh, get this one now. There is an expiration date, glory to God, to problems and obstacles. There is an expiration, just like that milk, the milk you got in the freezer right now, in the refrigerator should have been thrown out 2 weeks ago, there's an expiration. You picked it up in the store, but there was an expiration date to it. There's an expiration date to all problems and obstacles in our lives. And we act like and keep living as if this problem and obstacle is always going to be there. The idea, at some point I got it. I'll give you a scripture in just a moment. I have to accept the fact that this problem, I should not start working my life around this problem because this problem has an expiration date. So instead of me getting so comfortable with the problem and used to the obstacle and then just accepting the situation, I make sure that I got to be reminded, if I really want to overcome, then at this point, there's an expiration date to it. You know, my oldest daughter is a nurse. And one day she came out in our camp. Now, you know, and the kids just get a little too comfortable sometimes. And so she goes in here. And so, first of all, we don't take a whole lot of medicine and things like that anyway. There was problems. There were some things in there, probably from 1875. So she goes in there, and so she's drinking some water. And notices the medicine cabinet behind me. Now, everybody has this drawer with soy sauce and all like that. Then you have this other place where all the NyQuil and Pepto-Bismol, everything's kept there. So she's sitting there drinking water, and we're not even looking for anything. And she goes there, and then she's talking. Well, let me say what's going on in life. She looks at, and she's just talking and just throwing away all our medications, just throwing everything away because what she was doing was checking. Because the expiration date had already expired. Why are we holding on to medicine that's already expired? Why you hold on to a problem that's already expired? Why you hold on to an obstacle, I'm preaching after a while, that's already expired? Why you hold on to some hurt that already expired? There is an expiration date assigned to that problem. I'm telling you, the life may look huge and the problem may look big, but I got to remember what God has promised, that there is an expiration date. As with every spiritual principle, here's the scripture. Now, please write down Acts chapter 27. Just write the whole thing down and out. Let me talk about this. So, Acts chapter 27. In Acts chapter 27, Paul is going on his way to Rome as a prisoner. Paul, in his life, he's a tent maker, knew the seas very well. And as they're going, he told the people before they went, we should not go on this journey. Because we're going to face some danger. They're saying this point, what does a prisoner know about anything? And decided to go back in and proceed anyway. On a ship going to Rome. While they're on the ship, things get rough. They got to start throwing stuff overboard. Things looking bad. It's looking rough. And then the angel of the Lord comes in and says, be of good cheer. Because not only you, but everybody's going to make it. They're in the middle of a storm. They're at this point, Paul, they're thinking like, we should listen to Paul. And now here's the point. When God gives you revelation for something, and God and people don't follow it, don't go back and say, I told you so. I told you. We can't work the river. Now, that's the time to administer grace. Because all of us didn't listen to everything. Mothers come on, tell me. We didn't always listen to everything. So the point was, so Paul didn't get up and say, so Paul said at this point, now tactfully said, basically you should listen to me. But I got revelation that although we are in this storm right now, this storm is going on right now, the Lord told me that we're going to make it. Be of good cheer in the midst of your storm, because you're going to make it. Be of good cheer in the midst of all the damage, because you're going to make it. Be of good cheer. I know it doesn't look good, doesn't feel good, but at this point, be of good cheer. Why? Because it's an expiration date, and problems come to pass. They show up to pass. They didn't show up to stay. Don't go in here and make up the guest room for a problem. They're not going to be that long. Don't even put in a dinner setting place for them, because they got to go. Problems came to pass. Now, in Acts chapter 27, says right here in verse 44. In fact, this portion of scripture right here, well, for verses 43 and 44, one of my favorite sermon topics I've ever preached in life. Let me just tell you the rest of the story, then get to verse 44. So they are on the ship. Damage is going on. Throwing things overboard. God tells me, at this point, Paul gets a revelation, be of good cheer. Lord tells him, be of good cheer. You're going to make it to Rome. But here's what happens. That as they were going, the ship hit some rocks. And as a result of it, the ship was torn apart. And then it says over here in verses 43, some swam to shore. Some got planks. But it says others made it on broken pieces. Somebody here knows what it's like to make it on broken pieces. You thought you needed more, and God took the little you had and helped you make it anyway. You thought you needed everything whole. You needed to have all of this and all of that, but God said, I just need you to have a little bit of faith. I just need you to have a little bit of meal, the woman in the Old Testament. I just need you to have a little bit of trust in me and watch and turn and position yourself for what I've already done. So it says, some made it on planks, some swam, but some made it on broken pieces. But what does it say in verse 44? And it came to pass, they escaped safely to land. The problem, the storm did not last forever. It came to pass. Anybody ready to go right now and embrace the fact your problem came to pass? Your problem came to pass. Your situation came to pass. It came, I love it. It came to pass that they escaped safely. I'm going to tell you now, and here's what happened. So you have a captain on the ship watching after all these prisoners. If one prisoner escaped, that the captain or the guard there would be killed or mutilated. At this point, every prisoner made it. Everybody made it there. And in turn, they all made it. It came to pass. They all made it safely to land. Please don't give up in your storm. Please don't give up in your hurt. Please don't give up in the situation. Please don't give up in your mountain. At this point, I want you to know there is an expiration date on every problem and every obstacle. Somebody ought to give God one more hand clap and praise about the Lord. There's an expiration date here. So what happens here then? So I give you one other scripture. So that came, I'm sorry, first of all, from Acts chapter 27, 10 through 44, but 43 through 44, I'll just share it in. Got to give you one more scripture there, because I know right now there's a part of us still on principle one. I'm going to talk to my problem. We've been talking about our problem so long, we think that's the way to do it. I'm going to talk to my problem, scripture. Expiration date. It's hard for us to realize, because I'm the folk like, I had this problem all my life. It's an expiration date to every situation. Let's go back and take a look at another scripture. Now, right here, please read this with me. Let's just read this together, and I'll tell you where it comes from. Let's read this together. For our present troubles are what? Present troubles are small. Paul is writing this. Same Paul who made it wrong. Keep going, please. And won't last very long. Come on, let's read it with me again. For our present problems are small and won't last very long. 2 Corinthians 4:17, NLT. We have to know there's an expiration date to problems and obstacles in life. He says right here in NLT, Paul says right there, whatever you're going through right now is small in comparison to the glory you're about to receive. Whatever you're going through right now is nothing compared to the breakthrough you're about to see. So don't you break down before you break through, because God has already done something marvelous in your life. It's the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. Don't you give up right now, because what you're going through is small in comparison to what you're about to get. What for our present trouble is small, and it won't last very long. There's an expiration date. So what happens? So now, stop every problem you got. Stop looking. Where's the expiration date? On that tuna, where's the expiration date? On that romaine lettuce, where's the expiration date? Got to find an expiration date. What's the expiration date to make that happen as well? There's an expiration date that occurs then as well. So again, let's go back here. God have a big problem. Come on now, that's not. We're gonna stop there. Keep going. Problem. I have a big God. Anybody know you got a big God in this place today? Everybody's here, a big God in this place today. So let's say it again. I am, let's say this again. I am revolutionary. Why? I overcome all obstacles through Christ. Overcoming. So here's our primary question I wanted to kind of deal with today. I'm going to read the scripture in just a moment. What's the scripture? Here's our question that we're going to deal with all month long. Read this, please. What keeps us from overcoming? We were made to overcome. We were created to overcome. We were designed to overcome. What keeps us from overcoming? What is it that keeps us, that even though we see Goliath and see that big obstacle in the road and see all the challenges in life, we already know, and we spent last week and we'll spend the rest of this month talking about 1 John. 1 John only talks about overcoming. There's a whole book dedicated just overcoming and tells us about this. But look what happens here. So I want you to write down, if you would, this word wait. Wait. What keeps us from overcoming? Sometimes this weight is weighing us down. I'm not talking about the weight that comes between us. There's a weight, there's a spiritual weight. In fact, even in the book of Hebrews, it says, lay aside the weight and the sin that does so easily beset us. In other words, it's easy to walk around this weight. It said, lay aside, put it aside, stop it, don't let it you. Lay aside the weight and the sin, it says in Hebrews 4, that does so easily beset us. It's easy to carry around this weight. It's easy to carry around all these things. So I want to talk about this idea of what keeps us from overcoming weight. I'm only going to look at two things today, the W and the E. We'll pick up the other ones next week and the rest of the month. What keeps us from overcoming? Here's the W here. So anybody ever feel like this sister right here? Mm-hmm. You ever feel like that? Like you've got all this stuff is weighing you down. Concerned about this. Trying to get ahead and something happens. Everything's working great, then something blows up. And then we started in our mind thinking, we were talking about this last weekend in Bible study after church. that people have even believers had this thing. Since everything is going so well, something's about to happen bad. No, we're supposed to expect it to happen. We're supposed to expect the great and expect the best and expect more, because we serve a God from Ephesians 3:20, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask or think, according to the power that works within us. But how many of them have felt